So we like working with wood. We're used to it. It's our medium of choice for most projects. Our saw blades are low tooth count for wood. Our hands are calloused. They're not cut. We're not able to capitalize on the things that make working with metal cheaper and more time efficient. So the type of the work that we do generally has a lot of corners, a lot of complexities. I'm sitting on a concrete bar top. We have reclaimed floating shelves. Everything needs to be tied in and strong, and we're not set up to do that properly with metal. So we wanted to use wood for this fit out. We talked with our architect, and the type of building we have is a 3B construction type. It's a wood frame building with steel support columns, and it is fully sprinklered. So by right and by code, we're allowed to use wood framing for all of our non-bearing and all of our partition walls. So our inspector came in, he saw framing that was made of wood in a commercial space and immediately failed us. We pointed out the whole building's made of wood, it's all sprinklered. We tried citing the code. He said, you might be right, but you know, until the city stamps something specifically saying you can use wood, I'm not gonna pass you. So that was our first failed inspection, and we're still kind of reeling from it. Definitely a ding to the ego. So is it legal to use wood? Short answer, yes. Actual answer, it all depends. We're in a type 3B building. It's framed with wood. The exterior walls have a fire rating, and that's achieved through framing methods, insulation methods, exterior methods, but primarily a double layer of 5/8 sheetrock. Everything that we're doing is inside of there. 3B allows for the use of wood doesn't require fire rating in most cases for interior demising partitions. That's especially if they're not load bearing. We're in a relatively small building. That kind of fits into this code niche. When you get into larger buildings, you're typically limited to only metal, and the types of materials and types of assemblies are a lot more strict. But smaller buildings is generally a little more leeway. So in short, the actual answer is yes, but make sure you do your homework. So the most important question is, how can you make this process go smoothly? Say you've decided to use wood in a commercial setting. How do you make sure you don't get dinged? How do you make sure you're being safe? How do you make sure you don't fail an inspection? So chances are, if you're pulling a permit and you have inspectors, you have a design professional in charge of your project. Talk with them, make sure they include that you're using wood in your stamp drawings. Make sure this goes to the city, and make sure the city stamps something saying that you're gonna use wood. It makes it a lot more easy to go to the inspector and be like, you guys told me we could do this. Again, even though wood framing is allowed, we failed our inspection. It took us 1 month to get an amended permit for an inspector to come back in and say that we're good to go. We sat here with drywall for over a month, our clients lost money. It was embarrassing for us. It's something we definitely don't want to go through again. We could have, you know, really been on top of the architects and made sure they included the exact assembly we're going to do. We assumed that because we were operating within code, that we wouldn't have any problems when the inspectors came. The inspectors are stretched so thin. One inspector covers plumbing in our area. They cover mechanical in our area. They cover structural framing. They cover insulation. And as you know, most of you know, if you do a deep dive on YouTube, you can spend a lifetime studying one specific trade and not know everything. So it's really unfair to have these inspectors need to know everything, and it was unfair of us to put them in a position where we, you know, cite an arbitrary code and expect them to know that off the top of their heads. So next time we do wood in a commercial setting, we're going to make sure it's stamped on our plan. We're going to make sure that the city approves that, they see that. And you know, we might even ask the inspector on the initial inspection, be like, hey, we're using wood to frame this out. We just want to give you a heads up. Transparency is the best case practice for almost all of these inspections. We want to make sure this project keeps going smoothly. We want to make sure our future projects go smoothly, and we want to make sure yours go smoothly too. Thanks.